So, welcome to tutorial 2D. In this tutorial, we'll talk about reverb. That's one of my favorite topics. As a sound designer, I'm very often obliged by the image to apply a certain reverb to a room, like a room effect to Foleys, FX, voices, sometimes also music when we have diegetic music, meaning music that is played in the setting we are working with. And reverb is a topic which we can very well demonstrate in rooms. So, for example, we are here in the sound studio. A sound studio is usually a place with a very controlled acoustics. So when we go over here, we for example have elements that absorb sound, elements who reflect sound, like they diffuse the sound. And this happens because we have different distances where the sound wave goes into the material and again out. And so when I talk in here, I realize the sound spreads around me. That's the diffusion effect. Whereas in an absorber, the sound gets muffled. And that's the two basic principles in room acoustics. And it's also two variables that are present in the plugins we use in post-production. These used to be different, like Beatles records. They were recorded using natural reverb. So the studios they were working in, they were also kind of muffled during the recording, but during the mixing process, the sound would be played in a so-called echo chamber, like a room with a nice reverb, and then re-recorded by a microphone. And that was the reverb that was added to the music. Of course, this is very expensive. Imagine you have an echo chamber here only for the reverbs. So we do this with plugins in the software. Those plugins have the same parameters as we have here. Like usually we have diffusion, we have absorption. Of course, this is very expensive. Imagine you have an echo chamber here only for the reverbs. So we do this with plugins in the software. Those plugins have the same parameters as we have here. Like usually we have diffusion, we have absorption, and to demonstrate to you the effect of being in a room without a lot of absorption and diffusion. We will go out now quickly. And that's a whole complete different story, because we have, although I speak with the same level, we have a lot more reverb. And that means we have materials here that reflect more sound, meaning there is not so much absorption. And it also sounds a little bit strange, because the sound reflects from one side to the other. And when I clap now, you will realize what happens. The sound reflects from one side to the other, and when I clap now, we will realize what happens. So we have more reverb than in the studio, and sometimes it also goes back and forth for a few times, and it produces a kind of ring effect. Usually there's in a reverb plugin one variable that measures the size of the reverberation. That's the so-called reverberation time, and we count, that's maybe 2.5 to 3 seconds. Let's go out to the stairways, do this again. What I, for example, really like is the sound of this door closing. Check this out. Maybe 5 seconds. Let's do it again with the clap. So that's the basic parameters. For example, when you go in a church, you might also have a reverb time of 5 seconds. But of course, this is much different in a church than in here, because here we have parallel walls, and those parallel walls combined with hard materials combined for a reverb characteristic that is quite common for a building or a place like this. And also our room acoustic, our listening habits and listening experience lets us decide quite quickly in what kind of rooms we are. So in a reverb plugin, we will find many different room characteristics defined by reverberation time, size of the room, whether it's parallel or not, and the amount of absorption and diffusion. We can switch from the internal camera microphone to my microphone, and this of course also demonstrates the effect of being close to the sound source or being far away. This is the direct field I'm talking now, and this microphone of course is in the diffuse field. One thing to mention, which is very important doing post-production, especially for animation, is think twice where you record your sound sources. Most of the sound sources are, of course, recorded in the studio, because there we have the controlled acoustics. We don't have a long reverb. And by having a so-called natural recording without a lot of room acoustics applied, we can apply a reverb to it and apply those room characteristics with the plugin. We cannot do this with a source like this. If we add the reverb, it just sounds awful. It doesn't do what we need. Maybe the most difficult situations or like the most difficult logarithmics for reverb plugins are outside situations. This is computable. You can find nice algorithms for almost every room. But what I personally find quite difficult is find natural sounding outside algorithms, because you have much more reflections, you have more objects, you have for example outside the viscosity, you have long distances between the walls, so the sound comes back from far away. And let me tell you which reverb I like most. My favorite reverb is the reverb in a forest. So being in a forest, shouting out loud, clapping around, whatever. Check it out. Now we go back into the Reaper software, and we will I will demonstrate to you how you can apply reverb.